Hi everyone, today I'm going to be filming a kiss nail dress fashion that sticks tutorial, and I got these in my bellabox or lust have it package this month, and I have these in number 28 and they're the jeweled strips, and apparently they last up to 10 days. Now we want to start off with clean dry nails. I have a few jaggedy edges and a bit of a rough patch on mine, so I'm going to head in with a nail file to sort that problem out. The nail file I'm using is a glass one. I picked this up from a $2 store for $2, and I use glass nail files simply because I feel they're a lot less harsh and much more softer on your nail bed. These also, in my opinion, don't cause as much damage to your nail bed. The next step not everyone will need to do, however I like to use a cuticle remover on my nails whenever I'm going to do some sort of fancy manicure on them. The one that I'm using is a Sally Hansen one, and I picked this up on eBay for a few dollars, and they don't actually sell it in Australia, but I like this one because it has a squeezy tube and it's just easy to apply. Now I'm taking an orange stick to remove the excess sort of gunk off of my nail bed. I use the pointy end of this, and basically it's really gross, but after you've left the gel on your nail for a few minutes, you just grab the orange stick and you wipe off the excess cuticle gunk, which is completely foul. You now want to take a cotton pad. I'm using some cheap $2 ones because I don't fluff as much as the good brands, and some nail polish remover, and just wipe off any excess of the gel crap that I put on my nails before. You can obviously skip this step if you didn't use that. Now that my nails are clean and dry, I'm going in with the Foundation 2 Nail Tech brand base coat. This step is not necessary, but I thought it would aid in getting the sticky residue that's left over from the stickers off later. Again, this brand isn't sold in Australia, but I picked it off of eBay for a few dollars. It's finally time to put the stickers on our nails, guys. And first off, obviously, just like you would with like fake sticker nails, you have to find out the right size sticker for your nail bed. And this takes forever. It seriously took me, I don't know, like at least 10 to 15 minutes to find out which ones fit. And it's really hard to kind of work out from the top of the packet what will fit on your nail bed. And it took a long time. I'm sure you're all more than capable to work out how to stick the sticker on top of your nail. However, here's a small demonstration on how I did it. Basically, all I did was stick the nail on and then shape the end into a point like this, just to aid in trimming the edges off later on because my nails aren't very long. Now that we've gone ahead and stuck all these stickers on our nails and our nails look like something out of the Witches movie, we want to go ahead and take some scissors just to cut off the jaggedy edges that we've made from putting them into points. I just thought this would be easier instead of filing straight away, just to get rid of that excess that's created there. I'm just using the nail file that came with the Kiss products of this, and not my glass one, just because I'm rubbing away rhinestones and plastic and I don't want to wreck anything that I paid my whole $2 for. Your nails are basically complete at this point and looking oh so fabulous. However, I decided to go in with my Sesh Beat top coat, which I also bought from eBay. Sorry Aussies. And just kind of seal in the tops of my nails. I just thought this would help them from lifting later on in the process. And this top coat is wicked because it literally dries within about 40 seconds, and I love that. I know Sally Hansen does a quick drying top coat though, and you can pick that up from your local Priceline. Now that we've reached the end of the tutorial, your nails should look somewhat like this. I'm sure a lot better than this, and if not, then what the hell is wrong with you?
So that is the end of the tutorial. Here is the final result. I'm pretty happy with the effect of these. However, I can say that my left hand here, the strips I used had to be a little bit smaller, and on my right hand they were a bit bigger. I didn't really have enough of a selection for my nail bed size, I think these retail for $14, and originally I didn't think I would ever actually pay for them, but I probably would. So I'll see how long they last. Thank you for watching, and you can subscribe to my Twitter account if you want to, where I'm at Amaranth, just like it's spelled here. Please comment down below if you have any questions or queries, and I'll try and get back to you. Bye guys!